So in a previous video, I talked about the JDK version, Java version, that you should be using, or that I recommend you use as a developer or a student. And that video is up there if you want to check that. And the short answer is that I recommended using JDK 11, but check out that video for the reasons why. This video, I want to talk about the various offerings made by different JDK vendors. And that's companies who produce a version of the Java Development Kit. Because gone are the days where we used to have just a single version by Oracle, we've now got multiple versions. So I want to go through and talk about the various versions that are available to you and the options that you have as a developer or student these days. Now, speaking of options, I want to talk about another course that I've created, my Java Crash Course, which is to give you an option as a developer to learn Java a different way. So instead of going through my massive 77-hour masterclass, there's an option for you now to go through my Java Crash Course and learn Java quickly in as little as around 11 hours. So check out the link in the description below. All right, so welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. And we're talking about which JDK vendor you should choose, which product ultimately you should be using as a developer or a student, but also which JVM, Java Virtual Machine, which is basically the software that executes your Java code, which one you should be using as well. All right, so let's start off with Oracle because, of course, they're the current owners of the Java language. Now, Oracle produced two versions of JDK. They've got a commercial version as well as an open source version. Now, the commercial version is released under the Oracle Technology Network license, or our OTN license for short. Now, that's free for personal use for developing, testing, or demonstrating Java software. So if you're a developer or a student, you won't need to pay anything. You can use that version. But if you're a company and you're actually executing programs using the Java virtual machine that's included in that Java development kit, then you do need to pay. Now, Oracle have got various licensing options for you in that scenario, and I see the link in the description. You can go and check out their page, and depending on the model, there's a subscription, like there's a per monthly cost, or there's also various membership options, and you can pay a fee, and you get access to be able to use that in a commercial environment as well. But if you're just a developer or student, you can use that pretty well unrestricted for testing, for writing, and also demonstrating any Java programs you create. Right, so that's the first version, but Oracle also released an Open JDK version. Now, Open JDK is a version that is an open source version of the Java programming language and the Java development kit. Now, that's released under the GNU ClassPath Exception license. Now, if you know anything about open source, you'll know that the GNU license typically requires you to release the source code of any programs that you actually write, along with any components that you use that is basically licensed by the GNU or within the GNU license. So if you had some software that was released under that model, technically you have to either provide the source code in a bundled in a package or provide a mechanism for anyone to get that if they ask for it. But this is a revised version of that license. This is the GNU plus ClassPath Exception license. And that means that you don't need to provide the source code. So they've basically got an option there for you to still take advantage of the open source Java Development Kit without you having to release your own public source code. And obviously that would be something you wouldn't want to do normally as a developer if you're writing commercial software to release that. So for that reason, it's probably a really good thing for you to look at as a developer and even for commercial companies to look at because, of course, the source code doesn't need to be released. Now, in terms of the two versions, the commercial version and the open source version, they're both functionally identical. There's a few little changes in the two packages, but from a functional point of view, they're both identical. Now, the other advantage of looking at the paid version from Oracle is that there's paid commercial support available if you need that as a company. So that's another big thing, and probably larger companies will take advantage of that, companies that do need that ability to be able to get support if there's a need for it. Now, there's a lot of people who frown upon Oracle and say things along the lines, why should they charge for Java? But the reality is Oracle, like them or hate them, they are a commercial company and they're in this to make money as lots of companies are, perhaps most companies are. So is that really a bad thing? That they're actually now saying that there's a version there that to use one of their versions, the commercial version, you need to pay for it? I don't think it's particularly a big deal, particularly because there's an open source version that they also distribute that is available to you. And look, there's links in the description of this video talking about both versions and giving you access to check those out. I think it's a good thing to have options there. You can take advantage of the commercial one if you want, but there's also an open source option as well. Now, speaking of the Open JDK, there's lots of places to get a custom version of the Open JDK. Now, we'll start with one other website, adoptopenjdk.net. They've actually got pre-built JDKs with a choice of the Java virtual machine. Now, they are actually releasing the Open JDK, which is pretty cool. And they've got two options for the Java virtual machine. They've got the Hotspot JVM as well as Open J9. And you can see there on the screen there, that's pretty easy when you go to download it. You select your platform or it'll auto-find that for you. Then you select the version for the JDK that you want. And then you select whether you want the traditional Hotspot or the Open J9 versions of the JVM. Now, it doesn't really matter typically as a developer as to which one you use, because both of them are going to be they will certainly run your code. And I'll talk about some of the different reasons, pros and cons of JVMs later in the video. But the Hotspot JVM is the most widely deployed version of the Java virtual machine. And the Open J9 is a JVM alternative version, and it's got some pros and cons. Typically, one of the biggest pros is that it's an open source version of the Java virtual machine. It uses less memory. It's basically less memory hungry, and it's also faster in many typical applications. But you should really test the JVM, and it's a simple thing to do now because you can download both if you're choosing one for your particular app. But as a developer or student, the point here, it doesn't really matter that much which version you actually choose. And the reason for that is your code's going to run just fine on both of them. It's more a performance reason or memory reasons, which typically a large company would be needing to make a decision for their sort of server infrastructure. Now, IBM talk about their JDK and the Open J9 on this blog post, and there's a link to that also in the description. Lots of links in the description today. Now, IBM used the Open J9 product on their servers, and they use that still to this day, and they actually created the J9 version of the Java virtual machine, but then they released it as an open source product, and it's now called Open J9, and that's now maintained by the Eclipse Foundation as well. You can basically contribute to that and access that and use it free, which is pretty cool. All right, so that's one version, or two versions effectively you can get with different JVMs for the Open JDK. But another one that is quite, really what I think is pretty cool is Amazon Careto. Now that's another JDK, which has now got free support, which is pretty cool. And it's now used on pretty well all Amazon servers. So they've really gone to town on it and they're using it in all their production servers. Now, one great thing, one great reason to consider using Amazon's Careto is that James Gosling, the father of Java, he actually works at Amazon. And I know he tweeted a post saying he was pretty happy that Amazon have actually released their own version of the JDK and the JVM. Now, the other typical things that Amazon Careto are focusing on, you can see there that on this page is only two versions as of the time of shooting this video available, the version 8 of Java version and then the version 11 and long-term support. So basically, Amazon are focusing more on a long-term support of the Open JDK implementation, their own custom version, and they're making changes. And the good thing about it is that the changes they're making, they're contributing their changes back to the Open JDK project, which is a good thing, which means that ultimately any changes they make, and let's face it, Amazon are a big company, they've got lots of resources, well, those changes will be reflected back in other Open JDK implementations over time. So I think Amazon Careto, for those reasons, the fact that they are focusing on long-term support, free support is included. It's already been widely tested on Amazon's production servers. I mean, let's face it, wouldn't you be putting something in place that wouldn't give the best performance possible, because they've really been pushing that and have for some years now with their server offerings. So I think that's certainly a good alternative solution to the other options I've shown or talked about in this video. Now, a couple of other options to talk about include Red Hat and Azul. Now, both of these companies have got paid support available and their own custom version of an Open JDK. Now, Azul have got a non-free but very powerful JVM called Zing. Now, I like the clustering capabilities of that, and they're seeking more for performance. They're really trying to raise the performance of Java applications with their JVM. So that's certainly something to consider, but probably not for you as a developer or student, because it's more an enterprise company looking to deploy Java or the Java runtime, the Java virtual machine on their servers. They'll start assessing the performance reasons. So the point here with these two vendors, Red Hat and Azul, is both of these are based on the Open JDK, as I mentioned, and for that reason, you know, it's just another good alternative. And there's certainly lots of other versions of Open JDK from different vendors, but they are the main ones as of this point in time, and of course, new ones will sort of come on a regular basis. But I think it's important to try and stick to one that you're getting some form of support for, or at least getting updates on a regular basis. So leading into that now is, which version should you use as a student? Well, I think there's two good options here. The Adopt Open JDK version is pretty cool because it's really easy to install. And Amazon Careto is another good option. So either of those two options would probably be the ones that I would suggest to looking at first. The fact that Amazon's providing the long-term support version and free support, I think that's a big plus because you're going to get that support for a long time to come. But in general, having said that, any Open JDK implementation is probably worthwhile using. But again, keep in mind that the Oracle OTN version is still basically free as a developer or a student for personal use. So if you're just using that to create software, to test it or to demonstrate it, it's actually free. So that's a good thing. Now, what I'm going to be doing is uploading installation videos for Amazon Careto and also for the Adopt Open JDK in the future because I think they're the two good choices. I don't think there's any real reason these days to go to the Oracle paid version unless you've got a commercial product and you think you're going to be using that on your service or you're working for an employer who's using that paid version. But even with that said, with the choice of JVM these days, your code is going to run on any JVM anyway because usually these JVMs are fully tested to make sure that they meet the specifications and thus can run any Java code. So in general, you shouldn't have any issues. Irrespective of which choice you choose, you're going to get one that actually works for your program. It's just really down the track when you're looking to getting into deploying applications that you have to consider it. So my choice is Adopt Open JDK or Amazon Careto. All right, thanks for watching. I hope you got a lot out of this video. You've made it to the end of the video. If you're interested in more programming tips just like this one, click on the top rectangle over there. If you're interested in more programming tutorials, then click on the bottom rectangle. And if you're interested in subscribing to the channel, and why wouldn't you be, click on the subscribe button up here. Look forward to seeing you in another video.